After eating all those oysters with Mark, I feel really strong now. I feel I could create a beautiful oyster dish. Great oysters, really, really lovely, full of taste, squeeze of lemon juice, a splash of Tabasco. If you like that little bit of kick with your oysters, it would have been fine. But you know what? I'm going to create something a little bit different. I want to add a little bit of a kick to it, but at the same time, I want to be able to make sure that people who don't normally like things too spicy are actually able to have a bite of it. So I'm creating a pickled cucumber, just laying on the base of the oyster. And what we can also do is we can avoid that wateriness in the middle there, those seeds, which are terribly watery. So we've created a wonderful ribbony type salad to create that little bit of pickling there. So it's just a touch of sugar and some white wine vinegar in there. You could use a bit of lemon. Whisk away. Quite easy to add a little bit of chili powder or something like that, but I am going to be putting chilies and frying them off on top of the oysters. So we just want this to be a little bit different. Touch of salt too, that's it. And then in with our cucumber, which is just going to pickle up really lovely. Oh, you know what would be nice, a little bit of a dill. Do one of you just want to pop over there, just a little bit of a dill? Just a little bit. Do you want to do it? Yeah, you're in touch. Just behind you, bit of dill. Do you know what dill is? Does he know what dill is? Dill. I bet you he comes back with basil or something like that, won't he, eh? Oh, you're a lovely man.
On the house.
On the house. Oh, thank you very much indeed. Beautiful. That's it. That'll give that a lovely taste along with the oysters. All right, very simple. That's brilliant. Thanks for that, appreciate it. Pan on there, olive oil. That's it, I like it, you know that there. People say, why do you do that? Kind of makes you feel a bit looser, a bit happier about cooking. Shouldn't be so much of a chore, you know what I mean, you know? Enjoy it, really. Garlic cloves. I've got some garlic, I've taken it out of the skins. I've got some rather nice chilies that I got from the market this morning. Lots of different varieties there, actually. Love the idea of those red ones, because I'm going to combine it with some spring onion, a few of those. Look at these, aren't they just marvellous? When you get that, look at that. Ah, oh, Lady Godiva or something, look. Let's just chop that like that on the angle, incorporating some of those lovely greeny bits at the end there too. That's lovely, look at that. All of that's going to be lovely and crunchy. We're so used to getting garlic and just bashing it with a pan or putting it in a mincer or something like that. All I want to do here is just, can you see? I'm just slicing it like that. Not too thick, but at the same time thin enough so you get the slithers that are able to just saute very gently in the olive oil that I've got heating up there. All right, quite a bit of garlic, you can see that. All right, so this is going to be quite intense, but it's just wonderful flavours. Flavours that are going to complement it, especially when they get really crispy and crunchy. And that gentleman that went to get me the dill, he can't wait to try it. Is that right, sir? Yeah, absolutely. Looking very proud there. That's what I like. Chilies again. Can you see that on the angle? Just a little bit there. Look at the seeds. I don't mind that. All of that is just going into this pan. I'm going to turn up that heat now. And what I want to do is I want to cook this, but I don't want to brown it. All right, so I just want to kind of make it go a little bit golden. So it's going to take a few minutes on there. Check this out, guys. Have a little bit of a look in my pan here. You see what I mean? That's the beautiful different colours of the garlic and stuff. And when we get to that stage, just a little bit of goldenness to the edges. That can go straight into our bowl here, which is that absorbent kitchen paper. Take a good bit of salt and give them a good old toss like that. There you go.
Can't beat a nice spicy toss. Now for Mark's Bruny Island oysters. I'm going to deep fry them in a crispy batter. First, I'll coat them liberally in flour, then dip them in an egg and milk mixture, and finally into the panko crumbs to give them that all-important crunch. I'm frying those off at about 180 degrees for a couple of minutes to get that lovely golden finish.
Now, those lovely oyster shells, I think they're wonderful. I love the idea, the way you pick up an oyster and you pop that in your mouth. And I think we should stick with that. They're coming along really beautifully. Remember that cucumber that I pickled in the beginning? Just a little bit of that into our shell. Doesn't matter if it doesn't quite sit nicely. It's the attractiveness that all adds to it. That's going to help with the cooling of the chili that we've got with our gorgeous golden babies here. Really, really lovely. There they are.
I'm just going to garnish up our plate with some lovely shallots.
That's it. Chunk that in the middle.
And a few slices of fresh lime.
And those oysters. Okay, they're nice and crispy. They're going to be just right to eat now, guys. See, that's what you want, the right sort of temperature, so you can pop that into your mouth. Chopped up little crispy, crunchy chili and spring onion and garlic. You know, if it falls off a bit, it doesn't matter. That's the attractiveness of it. And there you have it. Beautiful. Wow. Spicy fried Bruny Island oysters with pickled cucumber. Come and get it.
Now, oysters aren't everyone's cup of tea, but I'm hoping the way I prepared them might win a few of those doubters over.
Is that good?
It's getting better. It's still getting better.
Delicious.
Is that really lovely? Yeah. Oh, thank you.
Really good.
Oh, wonderful. And you like that?
Yeah,
thumbs
really
up.
I love it.
Okay.
Thank you.
I think the people of Hobart seem to really, really enjoy that crispy, crunchy taste. And of course, the zinginess, the kicking of the chili, and then the refreshness of the cucumber.